back to my channel. Candace here, obviously. Let me just address, why the hell is it so hot outside on the first day of fall? I'm just over this heat, honestly, that's happening right now. And I just had to complain to someone real quick, so I hope you don't mind. I was reading my Cosmo magazine, and I absolutely love their advice column where, like, you write in and then the editor or whoever gives advice on, like, sex and dating and work and just literally every aspect. So I thought, hey, let's try to do a little Cosmo section about dating. I know this video is titled, If You Have Boy Problems, I Got Advice, or something like that. I posted Ask Me Your Dating Advice, so there's questions about girls, guys. We are including everyone in this. My advice is coming from me. Take it how you want and take it lightly because I'm obviously no expert whatsoever. But I feel like when it comes to dating, I have a pretty clear head. I can always see both sides. I'm not always gonna go with the girl just because people are like, guys suck, blah, blah, blah. Like, if you're wrong, I'm gonna let you know. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to my channel, turn on your notifications, and follow me on Instagram, guys. I've been doing little giveaways on my posts. My last post I did, I gave away $10 on Venmo if you commented on it. So make sure you guys follow me so you have chances to do little things like that because I love giving back and just giving you guys some money for like a coffee or a sandwich or whatever the hell you want to use it for. So make sure you follow me. Let's get into the questions. I have them all written down on my phone. I picked these specific questions because I feel like a lot of people deal with these problems. They're very common. Okay, first question. A guy gave me his number and now he is very short while texting. Does that mean he's not interested? So I feel like this can go with meeting someone in person, at a bar, or out if you have luck of meeting people at coffee shops. Like, good luck to you, that has never happened to me. I wish it did, but it didn't. Or on a dating app. Once you get to a point, you get the person's number, you're so excited, and then all of a sudden, they just kind of start being short. I 1000% understand why you're so confused if you think he's not interested. Like, I went through this so many times when I was on dating apps. My question to you is, have you guys set up a date yet? If you haven't set up a date to meet or go out, go grab coffee, just a date, if you haven't set up a date to go on a date, I feel like maybe he is starting to lose interest. You also don't know how many people he is talking to. He could be talking to 10 other girls right now and someone else he is matching with better and getting along with better, I'm sorry to say, but that happens. Sometimes people find people that match them better. Yes, I think it's shitty if he's leading you on, but to me what it sounds like, if you haven't set a date yet, I think yes, maybe he is losing interest because he's talking to other people, or maybe he's just busy with life. If you wanna see if he's still interested, why don't you text him and ask him out for coffee, or ask him out to drinks, or to go to the park and do a picnic. Ask him just to do something and see how he responds. If he says yes, 100%, set up a date and let that go. If he's kinda like, oh yeah, sometime, and not really sticking to it or trying to figure out a specific day, yeah, he's maybe not interested. On the other side of it, say if you've been texting, you set up a date, and you have it planned for next week, and he's kind of being short. I wouldn't overthink that too much, at least for myself. Before I even go on a date with someone, I do not text them very often. I will set up a date and not talk to them till like the day before and say, hey, are we still on for tomorrow? I don't really text someone that much until I meet them. So I guess this really takes into account dating apps if you got his number on. I'll talk to someone a bit on a dating app. If we hit it off quickly, I'm like, hey, let's set up a date. We set it up and I don't really talk to them during that point. So if you do have something set up, it may be, you know, he's waiting to see you on the date. So I wouldn't take too much offense to it. I would just follow up with him like the day before the date and say, hey, are we still on for tomorrow? Obviously, if he doesn't respond, he's an asshole and you deserve better. I've been hooking up with a fuckboy. We both agree we didn't want anything serious, but I ended up catching feelings. What do I do? So many people deal with this issue. A lot of people think, hey, I can keep feelings and sex separate, and a lot of people can and a lot of people can't. I think always being open and honest with the person the way to go. If you see your feelings growing more, I think you should say something to him. Simply say it in person. If you're nervous to say it in person, you could totally send it over text. And I would just say, hey, I just wanted to let you know where I'm feeling. I feel like I'm starting to grow feelings for you. If you don't feel mutual, I think it's best to cut this off. And I don't think anything is wrong with that. They can either simply reply, either say, yes, I'm catching feelings too, or no, I'm not. Yeah, it's gonna stop cutting things off, but it's gonna help you in the future, honestly. And you don't wanna be in a situation where you have such strong feelings and the other person doesn't. It's setting yourself up for disaster. And I think since you guys agreed it's nothing serious, it's just fuck buddies, that you need to say something because it's only fair for the both of you and especially for yourself. I'm dating multiple guys right now and I feel bad. Should I tell them I'm dating other people? I feel like everyone, no matter who you are, should be keeping your options open, especially if you're on a dating app or actively dating. I think you should be dating a couple people. Nothing wrong with going on dates with more than one person at a time. I know some people that's not for them, like Quincy, she could never do that, but I did that before. I was just talking and dating multiple people. And that's how it led me to realizing like who I really like. And I feel like it's not as much of a pressure to end something with someone because you know you have other people there. Does that make sense? Everyone is doing this while dating, guys and girls included. If someone is on a dating app, they are dating and talking to multiple people. You just have to realize that it's not just you. I know it sucks to say that and I hate that feeling, but it's not just you they're talking about or interested in. I think in your situation, it's a very normal thing. You can bring it up casually and say, as you know, like I'm on a dating app, I have been dating other people and I wanted to let you know. Or you could really not say anything. I don't think you owe it to someone that you're being very casual with, a couple dinner dates or so. I just think people kind of expect that in the dating world. If you genuinely feel terrible about dating multiple people, I think you should just let everyone that you're dating know. My girlfriend will randomly turn her Find My Friends location on and off. Is there something to worry about? Should I ask her about it? You should first make sure it's not because she's losing service where she's going. Say if she has a school up in the hills or something and there's low service. Also, it depends if there's really other things that she's doing that can make you feel kind of sketchy. If it's literally just her Find My Friends, I don't think it's really too much to worry about. If it really bothers you, you can bring it up. But I think if she's doing other things that can be sketchy, I think you should say something. Say, okay, it's her Find My Friends that are going on and off. She's also being very secretive about what she's doing. She seems like she's hiding stuff. Yes, I think then it's something to bring up about. But I think if it's just one scenario about the person, I really, really don't think it's enough to bring up. I feel like when one thing happens, I always end up overthinking it. I'm like, oh my god, he's doing this, that means he's doing this, and then like I go in a spiral and it comes to find out it is nothing that I thought, the anxiety of it, to be honest. So if it's just her Find My Friends app, I don't feel like there's any need to say anything. If it's multiple things, yes, say something. If you feel a certain way and it's weighing heavy on you, always say something. Always be open and honest. And if you're with the right person that understands you, then they should understand that you worry about this and it's okay. Talk it through. And the whole point of being in a relationship is working through things together and not being pit against each other and arguing. You guys wanna squash it together. It's not worth it to stress about. It's not worth it to get so worked up about it. Just ask the source what's up. I've been hooking up with this guy, no strings attached, but right after we have sex, he grabs his phone and starts texting other girls. Should I be upset? Oh, this is difficult. So me personally, I would be upset because I just gave this dude sex and he literally just like grabs his phone and is texting up the next hookup. What's difficult about it is it's no strings attached. If you truly don't feel anything for him, I think what it comes down to is what are you upset about? Are you upset that he's texting other girls like in a jealousy form? Are you upset that it's rude? If the fact you are upset that it's rude, yes, I agree with you. I would rather the person just be like, great sex and get out of bed, not lay there and text. But if it's more of a jealousy thing, I think you should talk about it. Obviously, there's some feelings that have grown there, but I think you can honestly just joke about it, at least like a friends with benefits situation. I feel like you're able to have those little jokey and lighthearted things. You could honestly just be like, do you have to text right after we have sex? I would rather you just leave at that point. You know, you could say something jokey or something sarcastic to kind of get it out there, but honestly, I feel like it's just guys don't understand, and I feel like that happens to so many people. What the fuck, dude? Like, you literally, we just had great sex and you're on your phone. I know girls can be the same exact way, but I only have experience with guys, so that's why I'm saying that. But I feel like guys can sometimes just like not think about it, so I think just saying something sarcastically, I'm starting to fall for my friend. She's affectionate to all of her friends, so I'm afraid I fell or misleading feelings, what should I do? When it comes to liking one of your friends, it's very difficult because you can't really distinguish if you're falling in love with the person or if you just love them as a friend. I think you really need to distinguish that. And how you said she's affectionate to all of her friends, and if you feel like that's a reason that you felt for her, you need to just take into account if she is affectionate to everyone. And if you feel like you caught feelings because she is more touchy and affectionate, she's like that with everyone. So that's not something just because it's you. It's the hard truth, but really cut that part out of the equation if that's how she is. I think if you truly caught feelings, you should say something. And if you're afraid of losing her as a friend, I don't think you have to worry about it. If she replies back, hey, I don't have feelings for you, it would be a normal thing to be like, just so you know, I'm gonna distance myself a little bit. I just need to kind of grow that distance between us, but don't worry, it's not a permanent thing. I just really need to worry about myself and my feelings right now. What's most important is you and how you're feeling. Sending a text, talking in person, a phone call, a FaceTime, and just saying, you know, I know you are affectionate towards everyone you are around. If she says no, do not try to be so upset about it. I know you're going to be, but just know that if she is such a great friend, she loves you so much, and I'm sure you love her so much as a person as well, that I'm sure she's great and she'll understand. And y'all, that is it for the questions. I hope I could help some of you out. I tried to give the best advice I could. Honestly, I don't even know how that went. I was just speaking of how I think. It's, you know, just advice that I would give to a friend, honestly. Let me know if you have any other dating questions down below in the comments. I will answer some of them. I will see you guys next time in my next videos. Peace.